Oh, Quiere comer.
Came down just for a
Overlooking the world famous Hoover Dam.
From here, you get a
stop
and remember.
raining, you will see the tallest concrete dam in the Western Hemisphere.
Big.
It stands 726 feet tall and stretches 244 feet across the top, only 78 feet across the base. It looks somewhat like an upside-down pyramid.
some kind of acid in my beer or something because people were flying in front of me. And now they're going backwards.
Hey, you are a Thank you. Sounds so excited to go to prison. But of course, it's
they're looking right ahead. We're sailing.
Proximity of that 22-acre rock. So in 1853, the army landed on Alcatraz.
Thank you. Series. Next to Kit is Magnum PI's red Ferrari. Now that is a Ferrari shell with a Volkswagen engine. It's a lot quieter and more conducive to filming. You're seeing some of the Back to the Future cars, including Biff's 1946 Ford convertible, maneuver-free, the very futuristic Pulsen Probe from the distant year of 2015. The future. Now the Flintstones cars are just prehistoric golf carts covered in fiberglass shells and painted to amazing detail to make the Hanna-Barbera cartoon come to life. Now, of course, we can talk about picture cars at Universal Studios, not mentioning our hit franchise, Fast and Furious, and those are just a few of the cars who have that have appeared in the franchise over the years. You'll notice the Jeep Wrangler Sahara from Jurassic World, and it's probably pretty lonely because if you look right next to it, the other car from Jurassic World, the Gyrosphere, was pulled for production. Now, that's because they just wrapped, a couple months ago, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom in Hawaii. They used the Gyrosphere for that. Gosling, Rain can be very romantic. So to enhance your studio tour, we're going to give you a demonstration of a practical rain effect. Now we're going to start with some thunder and lightning. If this was an actual movie set, you wouldn't hear the thunder because it would interfere with dialogue. So we would put that later on in post-production. The lightning is strobe lights sporadically flickering back and forth, but of course, you need rain for a rainstorm demonstration. Now, if you continue to look to your left, you're going to see giant sprinklers disguised as telephone poles. Those sprinklers are shooting the water straight up in the air. Gravity then pulls that water down, mimicking a natural rainfall. That's how we make it rain on film and TV using a practical effect. You'll notice that the raindrops from this demonstration are larger than they would occur naturally. That's so they show up better on camera. In the early days of our industry, powdered milk or ink were used to make rain show up better on camera. Of course, if it rains this much in an arid area like Old Mexico, it's not a flash flood. Now, the flash flood is a really cool mechanical effect that utilizes thousands of gallons of recycled water that gets filtered at the bottom of the set back up to a tank at the top of the hill to be activated by the next tour to go by. The entire process of resetting takes only 30 seconds. Now, the flash flood is an homage to our opening day ceremony. Our founder, Carl Lemley, decided to pull out all the stops.
I'm